This talk, which I am presenting to you, the title is, You Are the Creator. I will attempt to make you realize that you are the creator. Hum is the most traditional mantra, most natural mantra that we breathe in and out every second. So hum is another mantra which translates, I am that. Tat Tvam Asi is a Mahavakya in Vedantic Sanatan literature. And this translates to, you are that. Sai Baba said, I am God, you too are God. The only difference between you and me is while I know, you are completely unaware. You are the creator of the universe. You are the owner of the cosmos. Everything has come from you. You have created the beautiful earth. You have created the limitless sky. You have created Mother Nature. You own her. You have created the beautiful flowers, the breathtaking sceneries, serene jungles. You come into this world as a creator of a specific purpose chosen by your higher selves. This higher self is a sum total of the infinite, ever-pervading, ever-involving intelligence and the mass consciousness. You come here for a specific life purpose which is meant to evolve you and also serve the humanity in a major way with your unique talents. You have come here to serve the humanity in a bigger way because of your unique talents. You are specifically designed for the fulfillment of your purpose. The life conditions where you were born into were chosen to be part of that purpose. Your innate personality, your physical features, your talents were given to you for the work you were meant to do. This is your dream. Nothing gives you more happiness than fulfillment of your dreams. Nothing, whether it is money, material success, or name and fame. What gives you happiness is fulfillment of your dreams. You originally existed in a higher plane of existence where you are everything. You can have everything and you can create anything only by your thoughts. You have created this physical reality in a limited dimension so that you can evolve yourself from foundation to higher and live a human experience which you finally transcend and connect to the unlimited power that you are. To evolve your intelligence, you drill yourself through the school of experiences of life by bringing challenges your way. You throw obstacles your way so that you get qualified to rise up the ladder of life, to rise up the ladder of personal, professional, and materialistic success. As you keep on facing these obstacles and challenges with realized wisdom, and you learn from your mistakes and failures, you elevate yourself up the higher plane and get ready for more challenges. But if you develop fear, you stagnate at one level, and then you attract more tougher challenges till you realize your courage and wisdom to transcend that fear and move ahead. You keep on qualifying yourself till you learn the lessons. You use success as a motivator and failure as a teacher. Together, they navigate you to the higher planes of existence. So if you want to be a consistent creator, you have to come out of all fears. It is fears that attract struggles, obstacles, physical health problems. Fears poison your mind against creation. So, for this, let us try to understand what is fear. Let us try to understand the dictionary meaning of fear. Fear is just an anxious feeling caused by the anticipation of some imagined event or experience. It is just an anxious feeling caused by the anticipation of some imagined event or experience. Something like fear of getting bitten by a dog, or fear of rejection, or fear of being served an income tax notice. But what you'll be surprised is that there are only 5 kind of fears, and all other fears are actually constructed from the fears. First, extinction, which is also called the fear of death. The fear that we will no longer exist, it evokes a primary, fear within all of us. Next is mutilation. The fear that we will lose any part of our precious body structure. And at the same time, fear that our personal boundary will be invaded, or we will lose integrity of some organs. Imagine the fear we get, because we see a bug or a snake or a spider. Next is loss of control. It's a fear of being immobilized, paralyzed, overwhelmed, imprisoned by the circumstances which are beyond your control. It could be claustrophobia, or it could relate to relationships. Next is separation. Fear of losing someone or something that you love. It's a fear that we might no longer be loved or appreciated. And last, it is ego death. Fear of shame, humiliation, fear of losing the constructed identity of self-worth and lovability of self. Now, these fears happen only because of 5 reasons. The first is correct knowing. Second is incorrect knowing. Third is imagination. Fourth is deep sleep. And fifth is memory. Fear, like any other information, like any other emotion, only gives us information. Fear is meant to give us wisdom and understanding only. And what we have to do, we have to only focus on the fear of correct knowing. You know that, yes, this is there, this is going to happen. It's correct. But the other fears, incorrect knowing, we are misguided. We think it is going to happen. It's wrong. Deep sleep means somewhere from our DNA of our parents, we are getting some kind of fear. Memory, something that happened to somebody or ourselves in the past, we keep on recreating it. Imagination, we imagine. We see a coil of a rope and we think it's a snake. So first, what we have to do is, we have to see the fear and see that from where it is coming. And then focus only on the fear which is based on correct knowing. The moment you look at that fear, you will realize you have the power and tools in you to do it, to face it. Because no problem or no challenge comes to you till you have the right tools to face it. It's a law of nature. But for the other fears, imagination, deep sleep, memory, incorrect knowing, there is only one solution. Bring it to surface, bring it to awareness, see it with open eyes, and throw it. Now, let us try to understand that why do we develop fears? Right now, we're embarking on what are fears. But why do we develop fears? This is something very interesting. This happens because of judging. We are constantly in a state of judging. We judge ourselves, we judge people, and we judge situations. So now let us come to judging of people. We are constantly in a state where we are constantly judging people. We judge and categorize and give them different labels even before we start knowing them. And the more we get to know them, we judge them more. And the time comes when all our neighbors, family, friends, society, culture, countries, they all are stored in different compartments with proper labels. When we remove the label between bad and good, we realize that a perpetrator also could have been a victim sometime. And a victim also has got a chance to be a perpetrator. The only difference between a victim and a perpetrator is time, space, and circumstance. Yes or no? So what happens when we judge? When we judge people, we develop fears. We develop fear that we might be taken advantage of. We might be betrayed. We might be cheated. We develop discontentment, jealousy, powerlessness, ego, all because of judging. And then what happens? We attract lessons. We attract the same kinds of people because we have to become the creator. We have to become perfect. That's what we have been born for. So many people are stuck up in a cycle where they keep on meeting adverse people all the time and keep on utilizing much of their precious energy in fighting adverse kind of people. Now let us come to judging self. Most of us are constantly judging our own facials, or we are judging our structure. And we keep on judging our actions. Suppose we do something which we feel we should not do, which goes against what we feel, you know, the kind of person we want to be. We feel very less of ourselves. Suppose we have an extra scoop of ice cream or an extra glass of drink, or we don't go gymming, or we postpone things, we don't do well in our exams, we don't utilize an opportunity, we don't get success in somewhere, we start developing doubt, self-doubt, fears that probably I am not good enough. And because of this happen, because of this, what happens? We blame ourselves. And because we blame ourselves, we get drawn to abusive relationships, substance abuse. We get drawn to losses, failures in career, criticism, negativity, as an unconscious way of punishing ourselves. So, what is the solution out? What we have to do? We have to understand, we can't be perfect. The day we become perfect, we will join with God. We will continue doing mistakes and making the wrong choices. The only thing that we can do is accept that we have done a mistake. Accept that we have done something which we did not intend to do. Understand why did we do it? And take a resolve that I will not do it next time. Next comes to judging of situations. We constantly keep on judging situations. We write our exams and we wonder what will be the result. We go for an interview and wonder whether we will get the job or not. We work hard and we wonder whether we will get a promotion. We put in a lot of efforts in our business and then wonder whether we will make profit. So, because of this, what happens? We get drawn to negativity, doubt, guilt, blame, and then start attracting exactly the same situations because we are a creator of our thoughts. So understand, judging leads to expectations. And expectations is a byproduct of not knowing. When we don't know, we have expectation. When we don't know, we judge. When we don't know, we imagine. So the solution is that we have to develop our wisdom and understanding and awareness to know. Because when you know, you won't judge. You will know what is going to happen. You give an exam, you know how many marks I'm going to get. You go for an interview, you know the requirements of the company, you know your specific qualification, you know you're going to get it. You perform well in your job, you know what was the feedback of everybody, you know you're going to get a promotion. So understand that because we don't develop our wisdom and awareness, we get prone to expectations and judging. But understand one thing, that most of us, we actually live with a very big ego. We actually live with a very big ego where we see life only from our perspective. We just see that I worked hard, I should get good marks. I have done from morning 9 to 9, I'm working in my office, so I should get promotion. I have been proposing this girl and I'm committed to this girl, so she should accept. We see only the world only from our own perspective. We don't see from the other person's perspective or the situation's perspective. Whether you actually wrote the right answers, whether you framed them correctly, whether you analyzed the answers properly, whether in your company you worked from morning 9 to 9, but was your outcome liked by the company? Are you doing something to enhance the growth of the company? For the girl you are proposing, is she the kind of boy you will like? Is she seeing the kind of qualifications she is expecting? We are not seeing from everybody's perspective. And that is why, you know, we have got these failures. We have to understand that when we increase our awareness and understanding and start seeing situations from everybody's angle, from our angle, the market's angle, the other person's angle, the past, what happened in the past, what is the future forecast, what is the market condition, whether we are fitting the needs and desires properly or we are trying to fit a round nut and a square bolt. If we are able to align things properly, you realize that actually you can evolve the effective tools and methods to create the exact outcome for every event and become the creator of your destiny. Thank you.